The main arms dealers of the Cold War, the Warsaw Pact, and the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, primarily designed armored vehicles to meet their own needs. Later, with the increasing demand from foreign customers and the ever-changing development of international science and technology, Chinese engineers had to rethink their approach to developing combat vehicles, leading to the emergence of a unique Chinese school of tank design. Eventually, many technologies developed for foreign customers found their way into vehicles equipped by the People's Liberation Army as well. The Type 69 tank was initially developed for the PLA. It inherited most of its features from the Chinese version of the T-54A, known as the Type 59. The layout and armor arrangement remained unchanged, but the aiming systems, engine, and some internal components were replaced. One key innovation was a smoothbore gun based on the captured Soviet U-5TS. Although the armament ultimately disappointed Chinese military officials, a revised version with a different gun attracted foreign buyers. During the 1980s, China sold thousands of these tanks to Myanmar, Thailand, Zimbabwe, and other countries. The Type 69 was affordable, easy to operate and maintain, and offered adequate performance, ending up becoming the most exported tank from China so far. Moreover, China proved to be a shrewd supplier, sending hundreds of these tanks simultaneously to both Iran and Iraq during their conflict. Interestingly, the Type 69 was the first ever Chinese tank to be produced on an assembly line, which helped with meeting the high demand from various customers. After numerous upgrades, many Type 69 tanks are still in service today. For example, Bangladesh uses a version with a 105mm gun based on the British L7. During the 1980s, following further technological advancements achieved by Chinese engineers, the Type 85 main battle tank was developed. Initially, the type did not receive much interest from potential buyers, but the improved variant, the Type 85-2A, that was specifically developed to meet the requirements of foreign customers, was purchased by the Pakistani Army. By the late 1990s, the domestic variant of this tank was accepted for PLA service as the Type 96. By the late 20th century, China's engineering and scientific advancements truly paid off. Chinese state-owned defense contractor, Norinco, developed a new line of tanks for export. The MBT-2000 was an offshoot of the Type 90 project, designed to replace the outdated Type 59 for export markets. The active development phase occurred in the 1990s, and due to the changes in the global environment, the tank became a fusion of technologies from various countries. Early models were equipped with a transmission from company rethink, while later versions used power units from the Kharkiv Design Bureau. The tank was equipped with a 125mm gun similar to the Soviet 2A46, Chinese-developed ERA blocks, and electronics based on French designs. The MBT-2000 became an export model for Pakistan, Morocco, Myanmar, and Bangladesh. The most well-known version, the Al-Khalid, remains in service with Pakistan. China sought to build on this success but faced licensing issues with the Kharkiv power unit. For the MBT-2000's successor, the VT-4, Norinco developed its own automatic transmission and steering system. Additionally, a new generation ERA package improved the tank's overall survivability, and the latest version, introduced in 2022, was additionally fitted with an active protection system. Traditional buyers such as Pakistan and Thailand continued to appreciate the work of Chinese engineers, and a few years ago, Nigeria also acquired some VT-4s to replace its aging Vickers Mark III tanks, and even used them in their fight against terrorism. Given China's vast landscapes and varied climates, Norinco, towards the end of the Cold War, also developed a wide range of wheeled armored vehicles. Many of them found success in the international market. The WMA-301 wheeled tank was purchased by Sri Lanka and Iran, among others, while the ZSL-92 IFV was acquired by over 20 countries, including unusual buyers like Nepal and the Republic of Burundi. The ZBL-08 infantry fighting vehicle, along with its 105mm gun variant, the ZLT-11, also gained popularity, as did light tracked vehicles like the Type 62 and Type 63, which were designed for China's remote regions with complex logistical challenges. These vehicles represent China's early successes in the global arms market. Over the years, China continued to develop its military industry, maintaining a balance between affordability and technological advancement, between simplicity and efficiency. Norinco's most expensive equipment, however, is supplied almost exclusively to the PLA. For instance, only the PLA maintains a fleet of hundreds of ZTZ-99A tanks. There was one exception, though. In 2021, Tanzania presented one MBT belonging to the ZTZ-96 family at a military parade celebrating the country's independence. The PLA is active in lots of different regions, from the vast reaches of the Ordos and the Gobi Desert to tropical forests and highlands next to India and Afghanistan. Engineers adapted their vehicles to a variety of missions, from a full-scale standoff with the Soviet Union to localized military operations in the south. Many Chinese combat vehicles are highly sought after in the world, and many of them are available in War Thunder, including rare tanks in service of Bangladesh and Pakistan, the newest exports. Which Chinese export tanks do you like, though? Tell us in the comments below.